When an amoeba splits up, who gets the house?
Oh, I see.
Who gets the house?
Well, yes,
I thought the whole idea was that they split, they get two houses. It's some sort of perfect world of...
Do you know what sort of houses amoebas can build? I mean, they're single-celled, and it's just part of the amazing nature of all living creatures is that even incredibly simple ones, like an amoeba, you don't get much simpler, can actually build
a protective house.
They assemble grains of sand, and they make that. That protects them, even to the spikes. Those spikes are deliberite. They can, isn't it incredible?
Is that loads of grains of sand they pull around?
Yeah, each one of those. It's about the size of a full stop on an average newspaper.
Wow,
it's tiny.
That's insane. We've never heard that before.
That's actually
quite interesting.
Hooray! What happens is the amoeba goes along as a single-celled organism, and the odd bit of sand it absorbs and saves up, and some it uses to build this house. And then when it's time to split, it takes away the house, and the half it leaves behind has got all the building materials left, so it can quickly build its own house. So that's how they split it when they have a split.
Why have we never heard of that?
I don't know. I suppose, really.
They never mentioned that at school.
It's been a conspiracy to keep this information from us.
Your state agents come along and say, this desirable piece of sand with
in this increasingly
spikes on the
popular
this
part.
Is an amoeba. Not the kind we learned about at school, was the shame. I only wish we did. This is a shell building amoeba called Diffugium. It is often found, if any of you are amateur microscopists or have young reddies who are, you can often find it by squeezing the water out of a clump of wet moss. Diffugia often lives amongst moss. And this little amoeba builds a shell for itself. Here is pseudoperia, this is the little creature itself. And here is the shell that it makes. It goes around and picks up sand grains and glues them together to make this beautiful little flask. Now that's an idealized drawing that I've done there, so let me show you a real one. This is one fed and wrapped under the microscope. This is the mouth end, as it were, and there's a little spike on the end. And just look at the way that it's fitted together, all of these grains of sand. That's as much skill as you'll be getting somebody building a stone wall. The shape of it is absolutely perfectly flask shaped. This wonderful ellipsoid. And at the end, you've got this distinctive little spike.
Quite interesting.
Hooray!
We've never heard that before. Why have we never heard of that? They never mentioned that at school.
It's been a conspiracy to keep this information from us.
And it's beautifully built. Now, if you or I made something like that in evening classes, people would be quite impressed. And yet, we're humans. This, I want to point out, is a single celled amoeba. This is the lowliest form of life that we are supposed to understand exists. And yet this little thing doesn't just go crawling around like a shapeless blob of jelly. Some of the species, like the species of Diffugia, can actually build a house for themselves. Now compare that with the caddisfly. We all marveled at caddisfly larvae as kids, didn't we? And the way in which this little grub can scurry around at the bottom of the pond and can stick together little bits of pondweed and stem and old bits of leaves, nibble them into shape, and then glue them to form a little case for itself in which it can live. Well, there are two comparisons one has to make with that miraculous little creature. The one is that that is a larva which has got a brain and jaws and appendages and muscles and eyes and everything else that you need, whereas the amoeba is just a single cell with nothing. And the second point is that this shell is quite beautiful, whereas what the caddisfly larva makes is a bit of a ragbag bunch of rubbish. I mean, the house they make for themselves is perfectly functional, but it's not made neatly, it's not made tidily. And this exquisite vase-shaped shell that Diffugia manages to make for itself is an absolute microscopical miracle.